This afternoon we're going to try another little really tasty thing. It can actually be a meal, an entree, or it can be an appetizer. Today it's going to be an appetizer because we have some elegant dining coming up, which you will see shortly. We call this soused shrimp. And soused may be because it's cooked with a lot of this wonderful Martini and Rossi dry vermouth. So, and the shrimp, a small batch, we're making just a couple of dozen shrimp. The ingredients, we have butter, we have olive oil, we have garlic, and we have lemon. So we just start out with our camp kitchen stove and our small frying pan to cook this in, get a little heat going, to which we are going to add a fairly generous amount of butter in the pan, preferably. We've got our butter pretty well warmed up, and now we're going to add to that about an equivalent amount of olive oil, measuring it very carefully to get just exactly the right amount. And that always works. It makes the recipes come out much better. Turn the heat up slightly. So we get that going, and then to which we're going to add the juice of about one lemon. We may add a little bit more in a minute as that starts to cook. And then we're going to add our garlic. And there are four cloves of garlic in here. And if you're making a big batch, then we end up putting a lot more garlic in it, because one of the keys to this is very, very rich garlic and rich butter and olive oil flavor. So this will saute the garlic until it is just about right, kind of tender and starts to get a little translucent. You can't smell this in the picture, but if you could, that garlic aroma is just incredible. If we just had a way that somehow you could get the aroma in with the magic of the video and the sound, it would make this totally complete. So we're ready to add our shrimp, and we're going to add to that. Now the shrimp are going to cook in this until they get a little on the pink side. We don't want to overcook them because that results in them being tough. We want them to be very succulent. So again, we measure out a precise amount of vermouth, hence we call this soused shrimp, and we put a little dash of Tabasco, not a lot. Now these shrimp, by the way, have the skins on. They've been deveined. They've been washed carefully before I brought them out here. And a little Tabasco, a few little dashes, and a little bit of black pepper. And we're very, very close. They're just starting to get a little bit on the pink side. You can flip them over. If you have a great big pot full of these, you kind of stir them. You don't really have to turn them, but since we only have a few, we just kind of turn them over. You can see how they're starting to turn a little on the pink side. They're very, very close to being done. Okay, you can see that they're pink, they're done. I'm going to turn the heat off. And then, because I like to be sure that things are just right, we just kind of have to check it out. It's a good idea before serving something like this to make sure that everything is really in order. So you can take a little piece of French bread in the baguette, dip it into, that part is okay. Now, when you eat these, the way you eat them is you suck the juice off the shrimp, and then you peel the skin off. And then you can dip it back in the butter and garlic. And those are perfect. So there you have one last little bite. our soused shrimp. Wonderful appetizer, wonderful entree. Some people say you can throw away the shrimp and just dip your bread into the butter and garlic, and that makes a meal too. So whatever pleases you. They're perfect, they're wonderful, and we're going to have a taste of them in a few minutes. So easy to make, again, one pot, very easy to clean up, wonderful meal. Thank you.